Bonjour tout le monde. Quelle belle journée aujourd'hui. À la fin de la dernière élection, les Canadiens nous ont donné un mandat clair pour en finir avec la pandémie et avancer sur les priorités de tous les Canadiens d'un bout à l'autre de ce pays. Et derrière moi, je suis énormément content aujourd'hui de vous présenter l'équipe pour faire ce travail. Merci, mes amis. We have a team of familiar faces and new faces that are ready to put all their strengths, all their hard work towards delivering for Canadians in the coming years, continue to deliver on real change. There's a few things we know are top of mind for Canadians. First of all, ending the pandemic for good. Canada, as we all know, is a world leader on vaccination rates, but we're not out of this yet. We need to continue to remain vigilant, continue to support people struggling in places across the country, and continue to deliver on the priorities we laid out a few weeks ago on ending this pandemic. Whether it's vaccination mandates for federal public servants, whether it's moving forward to make sure that anyone getting on a plane or a train is fully vaccinated, we've moved forward on those. We continue to move forward with the provinces and territories on rolling out and paying for proof of vaccination certificates for both domestic use in the provinces, but internationally as well. And we're also going to be moving forward with legislation to better protect healthcare workers from harassment and intimidation on their way into work. Il faut garder les familles en sécurité et éviter les confinements, pas juste pour la santé mentale, pas juste pour la santé physique, mais aussi pour la reprise économique. Et ça, c'est l'autre grande priorité à laquelle les Canadiens s'attendent, qu'on s'attarde, de rebâtir une économie forte qui travaille pour tout le monde, qui sera inclusive, qui répondra aux défis de la relance avec de l'imagination, de la créativité, mais surtout de l'appui pour les industries, pour les gens qui vont créer des carrières pour l'avenir. C'est pour ça que nous sommes là pour continuer à appuyer les industries, les secteurs et les travailleurs qui sont durement frappés par la pandémie, tout en encourageant la relance dans les autres secteurs. We are there in continuing with a straightforward promise we made to Canadians many, many months ago, that we would have your backs as long as it took, as much as it took. And while we are still there to support the hard-hit industries from this pandemic and workers in those hard-hit lockdown areas, we know that part of having people's backs is making sure our economy keeps growing. We've had good numbers already. We committed to 1 million new jobs back in the last throne speech over a year ago. We've delivered on that. We're now recovered. 100% of the jobs we lost during this pandemic, the U.S. has only recovered about 3/4 of the jobs lost during the pandemic. But we know there's more to do, from tackling the housing crisis, making sure that affordability remains top of mind for everyone working to serve Canadians, and continuing to move forward on historic childcare agreements to bring families $10-a-day childcare right across the country. We still have work to do in New Brunswick, Alberta, and Ontario, as well as Northwest Territories and Nunavut, but I know we're going to get it done because families deserve that support. The same focus and urgency we brought to the fight against COVID, we have to bring to the other enormous crisis Canada and the world is facing, that is climate change. We know that fighting against climate change and preventing biodiversity loss are key for Canadians and for people around the world. That's what we're going to continue doing here at home while we head to Glasgow and encourage and challenge the world to do even more, go even faster, as Canada has. Il faut s'assurer que l'industrie pétrolière et gazière arrête d'augmenter ses émissions et commence à les réduire, tout en étant là pour appuyer les travailleurs dans ces industries-là à se trouver de nouvelles façons de travailler, des nouveaux emplois et des nouvelles carrières pour eux, pour leur famille, pour leur communauté. on va être là pour cette transition que nous amène la planète. On va continuer d'être là pour les gens. While we move forward on building a stronger economy, while we move forward on fighting climate change, we need to include reconciliation with Indigenous peoples in every job we take, in every step of the way. Last week, I visited the Kamloops Tsleil-Waututh, and it was an extraordinary moment to hear from them, to talk about the path forward, and to recommit ourselves to doing even more. We've done a lot, but there's so much more work to be done. We've lifted close to 120 long-term boil water advisories over the past years. We've built or renovated close to 200 schools. We've passed historic legislation like the UN Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous People to move forward in partnership. But we all know, and this entire team is committed to doing even more, even faster, in partnership with Indigenous peoples. Nous allons continuer de faire le travail pour livrer pour la classe moyenne, pour les familles, pour les aînés, pour les jeunes. Nous avons besoin de bâtir un Canada plus juste, plus vert, plus prospère. C'est exactement ce que nous allons faire en équipe. We have a solid team with experience, commitment, passion to serve this country. I can't wait to keep moving forward with them for everyone. Merci beaucoup tout le monde.